terms of value, the asteroid belt alone holds around 700 quintillion US dollars worth of precious minerals, which would translate to about 100 billion for each person on Earth. Just to give you an idea. Many of these asteroids contain valuable metals including iron, nickel, platinum, gold, and magnesium. These minerals have a high value on Earth, not just for jewellery, but also for industry and for the production of electronics. Davida holds various valuable materials including nickel, iron, and cobalt, and it's valued at around 27 quintillion US dollars. Is there potential for conflict to emerge between wealthy countries and developing countries seeking access to space resources? Well, unfortunately, there's always potential for conflict to emerge. If there's a race for valuable resources in space in which the wealthiest countries seize access to these materials, disrupt markets and resource prices on Earth, and the benefits are not shared with other countries, this is likely to lead to tensions. Well, as it currently stands, the high cost of these missions, as well as the technological requirements and the kind of expertise and experience that scientists need, means that only the wealthiest countries and companies would be able to explore and potentially mine asteroids. There is lots of scope for collaboration on missions with multiple countries working together. However, again, the money, expertise and experience could be a barrier for many countries, particularly those that have not yet developed a significant space sector.